Well, meanwhile, we're back on the track and we've got the 800 metres. We've got three semi-finals coming up for that.
And let's take you through the competitors in the first of those. There is the records to begin with. Look at that, 141.01. Rodal, 142. And there's some very, very fine performances this season already.
Well, we'll come back to that in a moment.
Here we have Yuhov of Russia. He's having his second attempt at 2.29, and he goes clear. So there are stacking up down at the high jump end where clearances are just raining in over this height of 2.29. Again, great foot placement. That takeoff foot taking all the pressure. Up he goes, transfers that horizontal speed to the vertical, and he arches over 2.29 on his second attempt.
Well, there is the lineup. Pechana of Brazil, Moradi of Iran, Kaki of Sudan, Bishot of Poland, Chemut of Kenya, Amos of Botswana, Marco of Spain, and Lafhauers of the Netherlands outside in lane nine. It's the first two plus the two fastest to the final, so this has got to be a true run race in every sense. It's going to be a tough one too. What form is Kaki in? Is he in the sort of form that we've seen last year? And he was the world number two. He's twice the world indoor champion. He loves to front run, but we've seen him doing otherwise recently. That's Pecana, four times the South American champion. This event, 145.31, his best. That's the time in which he qualified, bottom left of your screen. And second in his heat, actually, to qualify for this first heat of the semi-final round. Moradi, the Iranian record holder, indoors in eight at this event, 145.98 this season. Well, here's Abubaker Kaki. Erratic, yes. His best is 142.23 a couple of seasons ago, but erratic form this year. Now, Kashat is a good tactician, European indoor champion, European under-23 champion a couple of seasons ago. I saw him win the Diamond League race in London just before these championships. Chemut, the Kenyan, he's only 19. He was the Kenyan number three from their trials. You've got David Rudisha in your team, and you find it tough. This is Nigel Amos of Botswana, world junior champion, 143.11 at the age of 18. So how about that? Uninhibited, full of promise. Marco, semi-finalist in the world championships last year, was third in his heat. 145.14 is best set this season. And then Lafhauers of the Netherlands was sixth in the European Championships. He led the race into the finishing straight and got run down. He was second in his heat here. But only two to go through by right and two fastest to the final on Thursday. The first heat of this semi-final round of the men's 800 metres. World junior champion on the left, the Spaniard Marco. Just waiting to be called for. Nervous moments indeed. I wonder what thoughts are going through his mind. Just waiting for the exact time at which this race is scheduled to go. So the first heat of the men's 800 metres underway. It'll be very interesting to see who actually takes it on from the first bend and establishes it. Kaki, who loves to front run, saw him in the World Indoor Championships a few seasons ago, and he was a man who really enjoyed that. Pechana of Brazil has gone into, well, I was going to say into second place, but he's not now because the Kenyan Chemut is up there as well. And this is really quite quick. They really are motoring now. In fact, it's Amos in second place. So Kaki leads, Amos in second place. Chemut in third place. The Spaniard Marco in fourth place. Then Moradi. And the man who was in second for a brief moment, Pechana, finds himself free from the back now. But watch out for Kashot. He's right at the back of this group at the moment. And it is quite quick, isn't it? It's 51.01 at 400 metres. So this is going to be a very, very quick race.
Well, Kaki loves to front run, as you said, and he is making sure that it is a quick race, because with just two to go through from the semi-final, we've had some slip-ups sometimes in tactical affairs, and he's determined to run this his own way.
Yes, he is. A real battle between Amos, the world junior champion, and Chemut, the Kenyan. They're in second and third, and Hamad and Muradi of Iran is now in fourth place. And here comes Kashat on the outside. I said, watch out for him. He's a very good tactician. The pole is coming into third place. He needs to be in the top two. He's attacking Amos now. Kaki, who's faded in the home straight just recently, may well do the same again already. Kaki and Amos, the world junior champion, coming through, and Kaki's holding on. So Amos and Kaki will be the two qualifiers from this race, and it's Kaki that gets it. Amos in second, Kashat in third, then Chemut in fourth. But 1:44.51, well, Kaki established the tenor of that race, and 1:44.51 is a good time, and he looks as though, I thought just for a minute, he was going to falter down the straight, but not so.
Line up then for the second semi-final of the men's 800 metres. Gonzalez of Cuba, Bala of Qatar, Borzakowski of Russia, Lopez of Spain, Lewandowski of Poland, Simmons, USA, Rudisha, the one and only world record holder from Kenya, Osaji of Great Britain, and Mohammed of Egypt. This is Andy Gonzalez, the Cuban, who won the Pan American title last year, and this year the Ibero-American title. He's a good championship competitor. Not quite so quick as some of the runners, just outside 1:45, his personal best. This man, Usaid Abdulrahman Bala, was the Arab Games champion last year, comes from Qatar, and also with a man with a best just outside 1:45. Borzakowski, well, at his best, 1:42.47, he's the eighth fastest of all time, but of course we've got so accustomed to him hanging back. He can't afford to do that with the likes of the runners that he's got in this race. Kevin Lopez of Spain, he's taken the national record. He was set 10 years ago by Reina, who we'll see in the next race. And he's now run 1:43.74 this year. This is Marcin Lewandowski, European champion 2 years ago. Polish athlete, and the fast man with the best of 1:43.84. Nick Simmons, twice a world championship finalist. Semi-finalist in the last Olympics, five times the US champion. And here is the man who's really taken the 800 meter event by storm since he first appeared, David Rudisha. Two world records to his credit, and he's producing a pretty useful championship record since he took the world junior title 6 years ago. Rudisha. Andrew Osaji, the British champion now. Had a fine performance in the world indoors in Istanbul this winter. And he took the bronze medal. The crowd giving him every support. And finally, we have Hamada Mohammed of Egypt, second in the Pan Arab Games last year. But Rudisha, 1:41.54. He ran in the Paris Saint-Denis Diamond League meeting, a second and a half quicker than anyone else has managed this year. Father took an Olympic silver medal at the relay, and he'll want to go one better than that. Semi-final two of the 800 meters with David Rudisha out in lane seven. Just interesting to see how he runs this race. He's capable, of course, of dominating it any way he wants to. And already he's just shading it a little bit, maybe. Now he's content to see Gonzalez of Cuba taking up the running, but now the long striding Rudisha goes past Gonzalez, and it is Rudisha immediately followed by the Spaniard Kevin Lopez, and he's decided to run it rather like Kaki did in the previous race, to run it away from the field, make sure there's no problems, make sure there's no tripping or anything like that, make sure he runs at a pace that no one else can match perhaps. He's controlled.
Yeah, he is. He's been asking for 48.5, 49 second first 400s on the Diamond League circuit, and really he's very, very competitive. Look at Borzakowski, he knows where the danger is, and he knows that he's got to put the pressure on, but look at that little increase of pace as soon as Borzakowski came up onto his shoulder, and Rudisha goes away again, and you watch, there's a subtle increase of pace, and slowly he'll move away. It's not obvious, but he's gone.
But look, Borzakowski is running a very different type of race, isn't it? He knows he's got to run it differently against Rudisha. He's trapped by Nick Simmons, Osadji of Great Britain's getting the support of the crowd as he's just behind Lewandowski, the Pole in fourth place. So 600 metres going through 1:17.81, nearly identical to Kaki's time in the previous race. So it is David Rudisha, this great 800 metre runner, who comes into the home straight. The battle on for the second place. Simmons challenging Borzakowski. Here he goes though, Rudisha running away from the field. Andrew Osadji of Great Britain is coming up to challenge Nick Simmons. The battle on for second place. Rudisha has won it. Osadji has taken second. Simmons is in third. Borzakowski is fourth. Lewandowski is in fifth. A long way clear of the Spanish record holder, Lopez, who is sixth, and the other three men trailing in behind them. 1:44.35. David Rudisha. Oh, he looks a class apart. But Osadji is dancing in joy down there at the finish as well. The British athlete who's got through into second place with a fine run. Well, they must all be pretty pleased that Rudisha led them through to some quick times there. Simmons, 1:44.87, that probably will be enough to take him through to the final as well. Beautiful, beautiful sight there.
Well, that was interesting, wasn't it? Borzakowski tried to take the man on, watch this, and then as soon as he came alongside, just increased the pace a little, wouldn't let him in, wouldn't let him past, and then all of a sudden he just moves ahead. Look, there's no way around him, and he just moves away again. And in the home straight, look at Osadji for Great Britain. He's in what, 1, 2, 3, 4, fifth place, and running against Simmons of the United States, who's on the white, in the all red strip. And it's a real battle between those two, but Osadji gets himself into the final by right, with this being one of the two to qualify, and Simmons will have to wait with the others to see whether they can be the two, one of the two fastest qualifiers. But this man is just a different class. That is absolutely majestic, isn't it? Beautiful, beautiful running. He doesn't need pacemakers, although he uses them, he uses his training partner as one, but fantastic. The third semi-final, there's the lineup for you. Harris of Canada, Mohammed of Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, Solomon of USA, Aman of Ethiopia, Keaton of Kenya, Olivier of South Africa, Boss of France, and Reina of Spain. This is Harris, the Canadian champion. 1:45.97 is his best set this year in the heat. In fact, qualified by right, he was second in his heat, and he's got the inside leg. This is Mohammed of Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, 1:45.52, another personal best set this season. He's 21 years old. And this is Dwayne Solomon, the US indoor champion last year, third in the Olympic trials, but he's third in Monaco, and his personal best down to 1:43.44. So Aman, the Ethiopian, a record holder by the age of 17, he's only 18, 1:43.51. Won his heat. So many youngsters coming to the fore in these Olympic Games. That's Tim Kiptum, I should say, of Kenya. He's only 17, 1:43.94 as well. When you consider the sheer youth, Olivier of South Africa, he set his personal best in that Monaco race, 1:45.09 to 1:44.29. He was third in his heat here. And this is Bossa, France. Got a bronze in the Europeans in Barcelona recently. Yabus, 1:44.97. Well, Reiner came here as the Spanish record holder, but goes away. His teammate has taken it from him, so he's the former Spanish record holder now. Olympic semi-finalist in the last two Olympics, incidentally, so he's a good competitor. But once again, the first two plus two fastest through to the final on Thursday.
On your marks.
Aman of Ethiopia, 18. Keaton, 17. Boss, 20. The youth emerging. Now Harris has gone off pretty quickly on the inside. And so is Olivier. Olivier, the South African. And Solomon of the United States, also in the centre in the all-red strip. We'll see who comes across. I think it could be Aman, actually, when they emerge. But yes, you know, it's Solomon from Aman down at the back straight as they go through the 200-metre mark for the first time. The Frenchman Bush in third place, the Canadian Harris has tucked in on the inside now in third place as they enter the home straight for the first time. So Solomon controlling the race at the moment. Aman in second, Harris third, Bush fourth, then Mohammed and Keaton, the other youngster, with the Spaniard trailing the back at the moment with the South African Olivier. 51.18, a very respectable time indeed. And we shall see now how this second lap opens up. The American really putting the button down now as they go into the back straight, followed by Aman, the Ethiopian record holder. He got that record at the age of 17 in the red and green of Ethiopia there. But this is not over. Keetum, the youngster's coming through into third place ahead of Bus of France. And now the South African making some move. Olivier really hammering away. But it's only the first two to go through by right. The two youngsters are up in the first three, chasing the more experienced American. And Solomon leads. And Aman in second place. Keetum really working hard. And Solomon could be the one to be run out of this, having led all the way through. And he's going to be. The two youngsters are through. It's Aman who wins. And Keetum in second place, Solomon in third, and the time 1:44.34. And youth prevailed once again. That was a very, very good run by Aman and Keetum. Both of them are very strong in the home straight. So there really is a new group of 800-meter runners coming into the fore. And it's good to see, isn't it? Mohammed Aman, 1:44.34. Wow.
And down at the high jump, Robbie Grabas from Great Britain has his first attempt at 2 meters 33. Oh, he just seemed to just duck into that takeoff point, just sink a fraction, and didn't quite get up off it clean. Although it just tries to arch over it, and just catches it with the back of his calves. So Grabas, who's had a clean score sheet, 2:25 first time, 2:29 first time, has his first failure of the evening.
Well, this is where Solomon came under pressure from the two youngsters. He'd led all the way, looked to be totally in control, but just didn't have the power down the home straight. And he's a 1:43 man at his best, is Solomon, but he couldn't hold on the two youngsters, Keetum, I should say, and Aman, the leader there, the Ethiopian. He's a very good find, isn't he? And the Kenyan trailing him home.
Nonetheless, Solomon has made it. He broke 1:45 and has got through to the final.
Yes, there it is, the small queue. That confirms that. Aman and Kipton and Solomon does go through. And no doubt we'll get a list of all those who have actually gone through shortly.
Derek Druin, meanwhile, in the high jump, his second attempt at 2:33.
That's his second failure at 2:33. So these heights are now finding out, these high jumpers. We had 14, it whittled down to 7 as we came into 2:33, and now we're starting to feel the strain.
But this is the composition of the final, or will be the composition of the final of the 800 metres. Three teenagers, three men will be juniors next year. Aman there, and Amos, and Keetum. Rudisha, of course, looking absolutely supreme. Simmons and Solomon got through on times. So anyone who broke 1:45. Interesting that all the semis were fast, and we haven't seen that in recent championships. One notable failure, just missing out, Borzakowski.